Hello students and welcome back to the video lecture series of web programming. Today's topic is PHP arrays and string. I am your instructor Ms. Shruti Rawal. So let us start with the first topic. What are the different types of array that are possible in PHP? The first type of array is indexed array, and these array are the normal array that we have seen in every programming language, that is arrays with a numeric index starting from 0. The second type of array in PHP, that is associative array. Now, instead of the index that is starting from 0, if you associate a key with every value, then the key value is known as associative array. So basically this array values are associated with a named key instead of the index. And the last type of array is multidimensional array. Now this is nothing but one array containing another array, right? So that is multidimensional array. Now let us see one program and try to understand each of them. So here we are, and we are going to discuss each type of array. So the first array I told you was indexed array. And if you want to create an indexed array in PHP, here you can see that I have called a method array, right? So if you write this method, this is an inbuilt method in PHP, and inside that you can write comma separated array values. So whatever values you specify, that will basically take the index starting from 0. So this Volvo will take index 0, BMW will take index 1, and Toyota will take index 2, right? Individual assignments is also possible. Now if you want to count the length of array, so basically there is a function called count, and inside that you can pass the array variable name. So here you can see what is the array variable name, $cars. So I have called this function count, and inside that I have passed $cars. So it will basically count the array members, and it will return the length of the array, and I can assign this length to any other variable. For example, here I have returned one variable $arrayLength, right? So what will be the count that will be returned, because I have 1, 2 and 3 members of array, so the length of this array is 3. So this $arrayLength will consist of what? It will consist of 3, that is an integer 3. Now if I want to iterate to this indexed array, I can use the normal for loop that we have already seen, the syntax of for loop. So for, I have initialized a variable $x to 0, so $x is equal to 0, till what I want to iterate, because I want to iterate till the end of my array. And how to calculate the end of my array? I have already calculated the length of my array using count, and I have stored it in variable $arrayLength. So I can compare this variable with my variable in which I have stored the length, right? So $x less than $arrayLength and $x plus plus. Now why I have used less than and not less than equal to? Because this will return the actual length, so it will return 3. But if you want to iterate through the array, and if the index is starting from 0, your last member will be stored in which position? One less position than your length. So your Toyota will be stored in second position. So I am not including the last position, okay, because $arrayLength will be 3. So I am using $x less than $arrayLength and not less than equal to, right? Then I have incremented the variable, and inside that I have displayed the array values. It is very simple. You have to write the array name, that is $cars, and inside the square bracket you have to specify the variable name through which you are iterating the array, and which is the variable through which I am iterating the array, $x. So I have specified over here $x, right? So $cars, and inside the square bracket $x, that will give me the value of my array, that is when it is at 0th position, this particular thing will be Volvo. When it is at 1st position, this particular thing will display BMW, and when it is at 2nd position, this particular thing will display Toyota. And then echo BR for concatenating the brake. Okay, now let us run this program and see what is the output. So here is my PHP array. So here you can see that these are the three things that I am getting: Volvo, BMW and Toyota. It was all about indexed array, that is the normal numeric array. The next type of array is associative array. Now I have told you, if you want to create associative array instead of numeric index, you will have a named key which is associated with every value. So here again you are using the same inbuilt method array, but instead of writing a single value comma separated, you are writing the values in pair. That is, the first thing that you are specifying is the key. Then you have to use this operator, is equal to and greater than symbol, that is an arrow symbol actually, that is for associating the name, that is key name, with the value in your associative array. So here you can see the key I have first written is Shruti, that is a string type of key, and then I have used the association operator and I have specified the value. Then I have written comma, again I have specified the key, association operator, value, comma, key, association operator, value, right? So this is how you can specify or initialize your associative array that I have stored in which variable? Dollar age. So this dollar age is of type associative array, that is, it is consisting of key value pairs in array. Now if I want to iterate through this particular associative array, you can go for for each loop. Okay, so how to use this for each loop in this associative array? Let us see. So here I have written for each. Again, if you recall the syntax of for each, the first thing that you need to write was the array name, that in which you have want to iterate. So I want to iterate in which array? Dollar age array. So I have written dollar age. And then you have to write the keyword as, right? As what you want to iterate. So either you can, if you specify only one, if you specify only one variable over here, it will by default take the array value. But instead, whatever I have specified the whole syntax of key and value using the associative operator. So here dollar x is one variable, then I have specified my associative operator, that is equal to greater than, and after that I have specified another variable dollar x underscore value. So if I specify this thing, what it will take? It will replace this dollar x with the name, and this dollar x underscore value it will replace with the value, right? So dollar x will take Shruti and dollar x underscore value will take 35. So now you can see that in echo what I have written, key is equal to, and I have concatenated this dollar x. So basically the first time it iterates through this particular array, the key will be Shruti. So I will get key is equal to, and instead of dollar x, what will be the output that I get? Shruti. And then again I have concatenated a string, that is dollar value, and again the value of Shruti's age I have concatenated using this variable, that is dollar x underscore value. So this dollar underscore dollar x underscore value will be substituted by the actual value over here, that is 35, and then I have written echo br for the new line. So the first time it will iterate, I will get key is equal to Shruti, value is equal to 35. The second time this loop will iterate, I will get key is equal to Dhruvi, value is equal to 37. The third time it iterates, I will get key is equal to Jay, value is equal to 43, right? So let us run this program again and see what is the output. So I am just reloading this page and I am getting the output. Key is equal to Shruti, value is equal to 35. Key is equal to Dhruvi, value is equal to 37. Key is equal to Jay and value is equal to 43. So this is what I get as an output in associative array. Okay, the last type of array that we are going to see is multi-dimensional array. The last type of array is multi-dimensional array, and I have told you that multi-dimensional array is nothing but it is one array consisting of another array. So here let us see, I have again called this method array, and inside the parenthesis, in all other arrays, what were we declaring? We were either declaring the values of the array, that is array members, right? you were either declaring key value pair comma separated, but because this is a multi-dimensional array, I am declaring as an array member whole another array. So this is one array inside another array, right? So here you can see that I have specified another array, and inside that I have specified, and this array is of type indexed array, right? The array which I have specified inside this array is of type indexed, comma, the second member is also an array, that is also an indexed array, comma, the third member is also an array, that is of indexed array type, and comma, fourth member is also indexed array. So I have basically two dimensional array, that is I have one array inside another array and I have four members of this particular array. Now you may wonder that, ma'am, if I want to create three dimensional array, what is the procedure? You have this array, inside that you write an array, and inside this parenthesis also, instead of this indexed array, if I had specified array, 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 right, then that would have been three dimensional array. You can go in the deeper dimensional as much as possible, but three dimensional is the maximum limit which is recommended, otherwise the complexity gets increased, right? So here I have just specified the two dimensional array, and in two dimensional array, inside the first array I have four array members. Now if I want to iterate through this multi-dimensional array, because you can see that this is two dimensional array, so I have to specify two for loop. Instead of specifying only one for loop, I have to specify two for loop, right? So here I have specified the first for loop for $row is equal to 0, $row less than 4, $row plus plus. So this $row is the variable that I have used. I have started from 0, I have compared it, because you can see that there are, see, for this first array, if I want to iterate to the first array, there are basically 4 members, right? So I have to go till this whole iteration till 3, because index is starting from 0, I am writing less than 4. The next is I'll be displaying this $row, so the row number $row. Then I am concatenating something, that is so here an echo ul, because PHP provides us a facility in which we can use this normal HTML tags inside this echo and format the web page. So as soon as I write echo ul, what will happen, an unordered list will be formatted, and inside that you can see what I have written again for the second array, for this, that is for the column array. This is the first array that is now being iterated in the second for loop, and for that I have used which variable, call. So $call is equal to 0, call less than 3, call plus plus. So here you can see I have three members for the first array member. Now if I want to display what are the members of these particular indexed array, that is the first index array, what have I written? Echo, and inside that I have written li, that is a list item, and inside the list item what have I concatenated? $cars, row and column. So first 0th row and 0th column, right? So I'll be getting Volvo 22 and 18. That is what I'll be iterating. The second time when I iterate and my $row becomes 1, then I'll be getting to this second array, and then here I'll be getting BMW 15 and 13. The third time when I iterate, I'll be getting this array, and the fourth time when I iterate, I'll be getting this array, right? So let us reload this program and see. Yes, so here you can see that row number 0. For row number 0, what are the list item I am getting? Volvo 22 and 18. For the second row number, that is row number 1, I am getting this. For row number 2, I am getting this. And for row number 3, I am getting this. Right. This is only possible if you use two for loop, right, for the row and for the column. So this was a multi-dimensional array in PHP. Let us see how to use the sorting functions that are the inbuilt functions available in the array. So these are some of the methods that are available for sorting the array. Sort is used for sorting the numeric array in ascending order. Rsort is used for sorting it in descending order. Asort is used for sorting the associative array in ascending order, but according to the value. Okay, because we know that associative array consists of key and value pair. So either you can sort the associative array according to the key, or you can sort it according to value. If you want to sort it according to the value in ascending order, use asort. If you want to sort associative array in ascending order according to key, you have to use ksort. If you want to sort associative array in descending order according to the value, you can use arsort. And if you want to sort associative array according to key in descending order, you can use krsort. Okay, now let us run a program of this sorting and see how this works. So here you can see that I have created an array called $cars. Inside that I have specified a indexed array, right? So I have three array members taking index from 0, 1 and 2. Now I have called this method sort, and inside that I have passed $cars. So you know that when you call this, what will happen? This $cars array will be sorted in ascending order. Okay, so let us run this program and see whether my array is sorted or not. So I am getting BMW, Toyota and Volvo. So yes, alphabetically my array has been sorted. Now instead of sort, if I write rsort and reload, what happens? Exactly, it sorts the whole array in descending, in the reverse order. Now after sorting, I have basically displayed it, right, using the loop that we have seen already, how to display the array using the loop. So this is just for displaying the sorted array. Now if I have an associative array, here you can see that I have associative array with key value pairs. So I have three array members. If I apply asort and if I pass the array variable and if I use this for each loop to display the sorted array, asort was for sorting the associative array using value. So based on the value, it will be sorted in ascending order. So let us see. So here you can see that keys Shruti value is 35, keys Dhruvi value is 37, keys Jay value is 40. Based on value, the array is sorted. Now if you want to sort the associative array based on key and in ascending order, using a ksort you can do so. So if I reload this page, you can see that the array is sorted according to the key value. So the first thing that I'll get is key is equal to Dhruvi, the second I'll get key is equal to Jay, and third I'll get key is equal to Shruti, because alphabetically D comes first. So similarly you can check for other sorting methods. Okay, see some of the string functions used in PHP. The first is strlen. This returns the length of a string. So here you can see that if I call this strlen and inside that I am passing hello world. So what will be displayed? It will count the letters, and basically that is the length of this string, and it will display. So if you count it starting from hello, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So output will be 12. So it calculates the length of the string. The next is str underscore word underscore count. So basically it counts the space separated words in your string. So if you call this over here, so here you can see that I have called this str underscore word underscore count, and inside that I have passed hello space word. So basically there are two words which are space separated, so output will be 2. Okay, the next string functions is str rev. So basically this reverses the string. So if I called str rev and if I pass hello world inside it, what will be the output? The whole string will be displayed in reverse manner. The next is str pos. It searches for a specified text within a string. So if I call str pos, the first in the first argument, what is passed? The actual string is passed, that is hello world, comma, what is the word that you want to find in the string. So world is the word that you are finding in the string. What will be the output? It will display the position from where this word is starting. So your position, that is the index position, will be counted starting from which index? 0. So h will take 0th index, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and from 6th position this word is starting. So what will be the output? 6. It will specify the index number from which the word is starting. The next is str underscore replace. So basically it replaces the text within a string. So you will have to specify three things over here. So here you can see that I have called this str underscore replace. The first thing that I have specified in the argument is the word which I want to replace in the string. The second after comma is the word with which I want to replace the existing word, and the last is my actual string. So basically hello world is my actual string. World is the word that I want to replace. So that I have specified in the first position in the argument, and with which word I want to replace? With Dolly. So that I have specified in the second space in my argument. So instead of hello world in my string, if I output it now, I will get hello Dolly. So world has been replaced by Dolly. This has been done by using str underscore replace. So these are some of the string methods that are used widely. So this was all about arrays and string functions in PHP, and this was all about today's lecture. Thank you.